Everybody, let's get into it. Get stoned. Come on. Get started. Come on. Get started. Get started. Let's get it started. Quick note, this was about 3 weeks ago. I'm not traveling anymore. I'm social isolating, and you should be too. Hello guys, so I didn't do a single bit of vlogging for the whole trip. I was just really focused on the racing and everything to do with that because there was quite a lot of organisation. So I'm going to give a bit of a commentary over the whole video.
On your way to Lillers, traffic is light.
And it's all going to be, you know, looking back on it. So the race is called GP Lillers, or GP de la Ville de Lillers, something like that. Anyway, it's a UCI 1.2. I think it's the first 1.2 in France, I think. So maybe Belgium as well, not sure, at least it's on the same weekend. It's a popular season opener as a 1.2 for a lot of teams in Europe, or for quite a few teams in Europe. Anyway. It's not a flat course, it's got a couple of hills, which are a bit of a kicker. Anyway, booked the Eurotunnel, booked the Airbnb, but I'm pretty proud because I'm gonna actually do the whole thing, fuel, accommodation, everything for 40 quid a head. That's pretty good. Call me money saving expert because we finessed that. Anyway, first day we did a couple laps recce of the circuit. I quite like the circuit, it's got quite a few technical bits, which I'm a fan of, literally just this week. Got the Schwalbe Pro Ones. It's just the grip on those things. It's just so good. That technical section, it's like right, left, and it's quite a bit of fun actually, to be fair. I had a GoPro on, unfortunately, I didn't charge it. I thought I did, but I didn't. I didn't charge it, so I've got about 10 seconds of footage of us waiting to leave, and then that's it. So unfortunately, I can't bring you that. Went back to the Airbnb, and we ate a lot of rice. Hella rice, because, you know, the longest I've raced before is about 140k probably, so this is like a good 40k on top of what the longest race I've done, which is about, you know, it's about an hour longer than the longest race I've ever done.
This is a beautiful house, my man. How many square feet is this?
We drove up to the race in the morning, and let me tell you, it's just crazy. It's crazy because Arkea Samsic there, they've got their massive like team bus with all their names, and it's like, you know, they're, it's just crazy. Like, this is Nairo Quintana's team, man. It's mad. Anyway, so we're all getting ready. We've got like my mum's Mazda 3 and my friend's dad's Scooby-Doo van, and we're just rocking up and all these team cars and team vans. But it's like, you know, we made it work, and so I'm pretty proud. We did all that. It's pretty cool. So we're all getting ready. Doing our warm-up on the road. It's raining, by the way, and it's flipping freezing. I'm literally wearing my wetsuit, my skin suit. That's what I planned to wear, but it was too cold for that. So wetsuit, skin suit, thermal jersey, and then a jersey on top, because I can't be getting cold. I do not like at all.
I don't like sand.
So I'm all dressed up with pretty much every item of kit I have, and you know, on the start line, it's not too bad.
David Simek, quand nous avons départ.
Neutralized section, as always, to be fair, was pretty sketchy. Everyone's dive bombing everything. It's just pretty much sand. To be fair, the respect you get in a peloton, in that peloton, is more than I've ever seen in a nat B. Like, pretty much everyone, if they like accidentally knock you or whatever, they all say sorry. Like, everyone's just way more respectful, which is pretty interesting, actually. My view was, I'm gonna try and conserve as much as I can and hopefully have something for the sprint. You know, I was trying to finesse everything, every little thing, thinking about every possible way I could save energy and save power. So on the climb, I would be in a relatively good position at the bottom, and I would just move back if I would let myself roll back if need be, because there's no point, you know, sprinting up the climb, even if you can and you feel all right at the time. You want to save and save and save and save. So luckily, that technical section I was talking about was right at the end of the climb. So every single lap, I would drift back a little bit on the climb, move to the outside first corner, inside, and just weave around. And I think, I don't know, because it's wet, I think a lot of people were quite cautious about the cornering, but these are the tyres I rode all of last year, so I've got hella confidence. And man, I was just railing the inside, and I was literally every lap, I was probably making up about 20 riders, if not more, on that technical section. And I got the KOM down it as well, so that's pretty cool. Yeah, so like I said, I was just conserving energy. Unfortunately, one of our guys, David, he had a puncture, so that put him out. And yeah.
Come on, Red!
Yeah, so I was in a good place, but it was 10 laps of it was 10 laps of this 18.7 kilometer circuit, and yeah, I was feeling good with one lap to go. 20th wheel, I was really happy with my positioning. I'd gone for something, I was lined out.
Yep, that's me. You're probably wondering how I ended up in this situation.
20th wheel, one lap to go. I was like, okay, this could be pretty good. I'd used my gels. I had 12 gels, which wasn't enough, by the way. Not enough at all. I had 12 gels. I'd calculated for a gel every 20 minutes, which takes you up to 4 hours, and the race is 4.5 hours. And for some reason, I don't know why, I only had 12. I had more in my bag, I just didn't bring more than 12. So that was just, I don't really know what my brain did there. Anyway, so I was on the final lap, feeling okay on the first hill. I managed to hold most of my position, moved up again a bit on that technical section on the back side of the circuit, and then we came to this other hill. This is the second hill, and it's a bit of a kicker. It's quite a bit steeper. It's not as long, it's probably a minute, if that. But man, my legs blew, and you know, you've probably all been there. Like, it's not even painful at this point, it's like you're trying to tell your legs to go, and you're like, they're just going like as much as they will, and you can't tell them to go anymore. And I remember looking down like 450 watts, and it's just, I couldn't go any higher than that while all these guys, and I look at the front, I just see some Arkea Samsic guys sprinting up this hill. I'm like, no, please, no. Anyway, luckily, a few other guys came around me, and the gap wasn't that big, and I ended up getting back on. I managed to move up a fair amount, a good few wheels again, so I was still in the bunch. And with 1K to go, this right-hander into this main road, and it's just crosswind so strong. Every single lap, it would get shoved in the gutter, and you had to do a big effort. And of course, being the very last lap with 1K to go, it's going to be a hell of a big effort. So unfortunately, I just couldn't quite hang on to the wheels at that point. And yeah, I got distance with 1K to go, which is pretty sad. I cry every time.
Go on, Red! Go on, son! Go on, lad! Go on!
He's there! He's fucking there!
Yeah, so I ended up rolling in about 10 seconds off the back of the main group in the end, unfortunately, which was 51st place, which I guess I shouldn't be too annoyed about, considering it's my first UCI and it's my longest race by a long way. But you know, I was super ambitious, to be honest, with this race. I really wanted to get some UCI points, which is top 10, which, you know, if I tell people that, you know, they thought, oh, you're crazy, how could you possibly expect that for my first race? But I'm always going to be ambitious in terms of what I think I can do in terms of a race. So yeah, but it's the first one. Hopefully we can get some more in the rest of the season, and yeah, hopefully we can improve on that result. I was the second place British rider, which is pretty cool. I'll take that credential, because I'll take what I can get. So that's pretty cool. So after the race, I was absolutely wasted. I was so donezo. I'm not sure if I've ever been that finished at the end of a ride before. I was absolutely wrecked.
Oh man, that 40-40, fucking amazing, man. Brilliant job.
Got round. Top lad. Oh god. And that's the interview with Red Walters post-race. Dot race lad.
So afterwards, my friend showed me where he'd seen a bakery, because I said, the one thing I want to do in France is go to a French bakery. It's like, you got to. I got a chocolate eclair. The cream was chocolate. What's up with that? Is that normal in France? If you're French, please tell me, because I was under the impression that chocolate eclairs, they got chocolate on the top and plain cream in the middle. But I don't know. I'm not a chef. I'm not a bakery, so. After to be fair, it was still really nice, so I don't know why I'm complaining. Yeah, so then we drove back. Anyway, that's going to be all from this video. I hope you enjoyed, and thanks for watching.